This is the solution to quiz two. Okay, so f and g are functions satisfying this table of values, and c is their composition. And we want to evaluate the derivative of c at 3. Well, that's saying that c evaluated at x is f evaluated at g of x. That's what the composition means. And then according to the chain rule, the derivative of c evaluated at x is the derivative of f evaluated at g of x, and then multiplied by the derivative of g evaluated at x. This is the chain rule. Then, at the specific value of 3, x is 3, so at x is 3, the derivative evaluated at 3 is the derivative of f evaluated at g of 3 multiplied by the derivative of g evaluated at 3. So what we must do is perform a sequence of lookups then. So, in the first place, so this will be derivative of f evaluated at g of 3. Well, g of 3 is 9, so we're using g of 3 is 9. So a 9 goes in here. And then multiplied by the derivative of g at 3, well, that means that we'll use, maybe I'll color code these. So we're using this red 9 here. The derivative of g at 3 is 2. So here this is now a 2. And then now we have one more lookup to do. So that would be the derivative of c evaluated at 3 is, we need to look up f prime evaluated at 9. So f prime evaluated at 9 is 8. So that would be 8 multiplied by 2. Is 16. Okay, find the equation of the tangent line. Okay, we established in the previous part that the slope is 16, and the point, a point. Well, we know that x0 is 3, y0 will be c of 3, but c of 3 is f of g of 3, g of 3 is 9, and then f of 9, this is the last lookup here, f of 9 happens to be 9. Okay, so that's just 9. And therefore the equation y minus y0 is m multiplied by x minus x0. So y minus 9 is 16 times x minus 3. Y minus 9 is 16x minus 48. And then adding 9 to both sides, that yields y is 16x, and then minus what? So 48 minus 9. 39. Okay. So find and classify all relative extrema. Okay. So the first step is to find the natural domain. The natural domain is all x, because f is a polynomial. Now we need to find the critical points. Well, the derivative of that function is 20x to 4. Minus 20x to 3 minus 120x to 2. And then we can simplify this. All of them have x squared and also 20 in common. So we should be able to factor it in a way that looks like that. So 20x squared. Doing that, the first term in the parentheses would be x squared, and then minus x, and then minus 6. Okay, and then does that quadratic factor? Yeah, of course it does. So then the derivative would be 20x squared, and then multiplied by x minus 3 multiplied by x plus 2. Okay, so there's two varieties of critical points. The first variety is when the derivative is undefined. Okay, so there are no points, because that is always defined. And then the other kind is when the derivative is zero, and that occurs at negative 2, 0, and 3. Okay, so then the third step is the construction of the slope chart. So we take all the things that we found. So because the natural domain was all x, that means that there's no breaks in the natural domain. So we're going to use that piece of information, and we're going to use this piece of information and this piece of information, and combine all of these into here, and we plot all the things that we found from here. So there are nothing from here, nothing from here, three things from here. Okay, here they are. Negative 2, 0. And okay, then in each one of those regions, we'll select a test point. So how about -3 in here, -1 in here, +1 in here, and 4 in here. And we're going to take all of these test points, take those test points, and we're going to plug them into this simplified version of the derivative and check for sign. Okay, so plugging -3 in, well, 20 is positive, so I'll just write positive, and then plugging in -3, that would be negative squared, and then plugging in -3, that's -6, which is negative, and plugging in -3 there, that's negative. In the next region, plugging in -1, 20 is positive, then we have negative squared, and then negative, and then positive. Okay, plugging in 1 again, so 20 is positive, then we square that positive 1, and then the next one would be negative, and the next one positive. And then finally, 20 is positive. 4 squared, well, that's positive squared. Positive, positive. Okay, so the overall sign in each region is therefore positive in the leftmost region, and then negative, because there's an odd number of negatives. Then negative again. And then positive. Okay, so that's the slope chart. Well, let's draw the actual slope symbols. So since this has positive sign, the positive slope symbol is like this, and this negative slope symbol is like this, and then negative again, and then positive. So you can see where the extrema are from the chart. You're going to have an extrema here. Okay, this one's going to end up being a candidate. Candidate relative max, and this one is a candidate relative min. And you can see that because the slope symbols are indicative of there being a max there and a min there. So step 4, we can make our conclusions. Okay, so these are just candidates, okay, and the question of whether or not they truly are relative extrema is, well, are those two points, are x equal to -2 and x equal to 3, really extrema? And the answer is yes, because f is a polynomial. So that means that the graph of f is continuous, there's no breaks, so no funny business is happening at those places, and therefore there is a relative max at x is negative 2, and there is a relative min at x is 3. Okay. So in other words, according to this story, the electrical power P of a circuit at time t is given by that. We want to maximize P. Okay, we'll do that. I'll do it using a slope chart. So using a slope chart. So in the first place, let's figure out the natural domain. So, because this is a physical problem, which presumably has a beginning, that means that the natural domain we're going to take to be t greater than or equal to 0, because nothing happened before the experiment started, and the individual factors, t and exponential of negative 2t, have no restrictions on their domain, so that's the natural domain. 2, let's find the critical points. Okay, so then we'll need to compute the derivative. Well, this will be done using the product rule. So the derivative of t is 1, and then multiplied by exponential of negative 2t, and then plus t multiplied by the derivative of exponential of negative 2t. Well, that's exponential of negative 2t, and then multiplied by negative 2 for the chain rule. Okay, so now let's simplify that as much as possible. So the derivative is exponential negative 2t, because the 1 is implied, and then minus 2t exponential negative 2t. I can see that there's a common factor of exponential negative 2t. So I'll factor it out and get 1 minus 2t exponential negative 2t. And then, because I'm about to do some algebra with this, for algebraic purposes, it's easier to express this exponential in a denominator in the following way. So 1 minus 2t divided by exponential of 2t. Okay, so there's two kinds of critical points. One of them is when the derivative of t is undefined. Well, the only place that we could have a problem is if the exponential of negative 2t, if the exponential of 2t is 0. That is to say, if we're dividing by 0, but that's not possible. So there's none. And the reason in the end is that the exponential of x, for any x, is positive. So the exponential of 2t is positive. Okay, so then we want to know, how about when the derivative of t is 0? Well, the derivative of t is 0, the derivative of p at t is 0, exactly when the numerator is 0, so 1 minus 2t is 0, and that occurs only at t is half. Okay. So now we're going to make the chart. So we're going to take the natural domain whole real line, and we're going to see what happens here. So this information is saying that we only need to consider from 0 to the right. Okay, so nothing need happen to the left of 0. We also need to consider this and this. So combining these three pieces, okay, that tells us that there's just one fence post. T is a half. So let's choose some test points. How about 1/4 and 1? So if we plug those values, these values, into the simplified derivative there. So if you plug in 1/4 into the numerator, 1 minus 2 over 4. So that's 1 minus 1/2. That's positive. And then divided by the exponential of anything is positive. So that's positive over positive. And then plugging in 1 minus 2, that's negative, so this would be negative over positive. So then the overall sign in the left region is positive, so that it's increasing slope. And in the right region it's negative, so decreasing. And now we're able to make a conclusion. And that is t equal to 1/2 is when the maximum occurs. So when maximum power occurs. So that's the answer to part A. And then the answer to part B is, what is that maximum power? So for part B, P of 1/2, that is 1/2 times exponential of negative 2 times 1/2, so exponential of negative 1, so that's equal to P of 1/2 is 1 over 2e is the maximum.